speaker, Luis Fernando Mustario Martins, comes from La Paz in Bolivia. Since he was 13, Luis Fernando has had a physical contact experience with extraterrestrials from the planet Venus and Ganymede, one of Jupiter's moons, as well as the inner Earth being called the Elders. For over 30 years, he has been speaking about his experiences and also been holding contact preparation courses in several countries around the world. They're going to be such a contact preparation course on this Monday, 13th, here in this hotel. Okay, he has published 5 books and the 2 that have been translated into English, he has brought with him here. Luis Fernando's presentation will be given in Spanish and translated into English as he speaks. Also, a big thank you to our interpreter, Guna Eribaren Dorfes, who came to the rescue. A great welcome to you.
Muy buenas tardes a todos.
Good afternoon to everyone.
Es en verdad una inmensa alegría tener la oportunidad de encontrarme aquí en Bergen, en verdad, por primera vez.
It's a pleasure for me to be here in Bergen for the first time.
Espero que no sea la última.
And I hope it won't be the last either.
Pero ante todo quisiera agradecer a Terje y a su pareja, Ann-Kirsten.
But first of all, I would like to thank Terje and his partner, Kristin.
A quienes pido un caluroso aplauso.
To whom I
por ser los culpables de que estemos acá.
They're guilty to the reason that we're here.
Realmente estos eventos crean la oportunidad para que la esencia del mensaje de quienes hemos tenido estas maravillosas experiencias pueda llegar a todos.
These events made it possible so that the essence of our message reach everyone.
Sabemos que el tiempo es corto en los congresos.
We know that we have little time in these kind of congresses.
Así que brevemente vamos a tratar de sintetizar más de 40 años de experiencias de contacto.
So that in short we will be able to synthesize more of 40 years of contacts.
En las entrevistas en distintas partes del mundo.
In interviews in different parts of the world.
Los periodistas me preguntaban.
The journalists were asking me. Luis Fernando, how can you speak so naturally about your being in Venus? What happens is that this contact didn't change me, it formed me. Since I was 13, I was so lucky to have this kind of experiences.
Sin embargo, ya desde los 8 años,
On the other hand, I was having dreams, I was having visions, I was seeing lights. I was having different perceptions. I didn't know how to interpret that, not only me, but also the members of my family and my friends. We were contacted directly. Then I was living in South Peru, in the city of Tacna.
Y es en esta ciudad que justamente, al mejor estilo de las películas de Steven Spielberg.
It was in this city, in the best styles of Steven Spielberg films.
Recibimos varias personas la comunicación telepática de desplazarnos 50 kilómetros fuera de la ciudad.
We were several people, and we received this telepathic communication to be transported 50 kilometers out of this city.
A un lugar que se conoce como Chuschuco.
This was a place known as Chuschuco.
Es un lugar de aguas termales, muchas concentraciones minerales.
This is a place with hot springs, many mineral concentrations.
Después usan estos seres para el desplazamiento de sus naves.
And we got to know afterwards from these beings, this place benefited, prompted these experiences. We were, there were 17 people coming there. We were located in the top of these mountains, surrounded this place. And in the eight in the evening, it was the determined time for this encounter. This time, and not only one, two objects were present. The first one was suspended in among these hills. The distance in front of us, it was around 2,000 meters in front of us from the place we were. The shape of this object was lenticular with a perfect yellow color. And it started moving slowly above these hills, intensifying its light. And illuminated all the environment as if it were in the middle of the day. The fuselage sometimes went off. And you could appreciate then the metallic structure of this object. As to that moment, that it became very little and it vanished in the horizon. This first object disappeared immediately. I felt myself very motivated to look to above from the place we were in. And the thing that immediately caught my attention was the fuselage of a second object. But this time the characteristics were completely different. The color, it wasn't an intense yellow any longer. It was more like a fluorescent tube with an orangey color. And it maintained itself suspended in space. And it was just in this moment when several of us started to perceive telepathic communications. Telepathy, for those who do not know that, is the transmission of thoughts from the distance. Then it doesn't require and it doesn't even recognize a language. And this is just the tool that these beings use to communicate with us. Then they told us that they weren't going to descend. That we weren't ready neither physically nor emotionally to be in direct contact with them. But if we so wanted, we could start a preparation process in the physical level, in the mental level, and in the spiritual level. And so that we could increase so we can increase the vibratory frequency of our bodies. To enable that way the possibility of contact. Why and what for? The only thing that makes us different from them is time. They explained to us that to discover the truth, they require two people. One who can tell it, and one who can listen to it. But the one who tells that is the one who already had been listening to it. So the thing that makes us different is time. That's the thing, that's the one thing that makes us different from them. Time. And they started their evolutive process millions and millions and millions of years before us. And this experience has allowed them to approach us. To tell us that if we're playing with fire, we can get burned. And not only now, but from millions and millions of years ago, they had been assisting us technically and spiritually. And they retook the possibility of communication in this time. Because they think that our humanity is living a time definitive and definitory. In which both humanity and Earth they have either discovered themselves or vanish. But this is happening now more than ever before in the history of the Earth. It's now for the first time that us as human beings we have to assume our definitive role. I'm not here with you today to convince all of you that my experience is real. The reason I'm to here for is to share with you this part of my experience. The thing that has made my experience different from other contact from other experiences of contact is that we're asking all of you that you have to live your own experiences. And that you take from there your own conclusions. In the course of my 38 years of permanent contact, I have had the opportunity to invite journalists. I have invited two very renowned people in the sphere of contact. And for example, in 1990, then something very particular was happening in the ex-Soviet Union. In 1990, for those who were investigating the geological theme, an ovni, a UFO, descended in the Russian city of Voronezh. In this city, in the district 33 of the former Soviet Union, not only that this object descended in the daylight, in the middle of the daylight, but not only that, but three of the crew of this spaceship were having a walk in the middle of the place. This motivated a great fuss in the international level. And the TASS agency asked to his correspondents that they were to investigate this thing to international at an international level.
Para hacer una presentación del fenómeno en plena plaza en Rusia.
To make a presentation of this phenomena in the square in this square of, in Russia.
Entonces corresponsal de la TAS en Bolivia.
Then the TAS correspondent in Bolivia.
Llamado Valentin Uvarov.
He was called Valentin Uvarov.
Me gustó y me entrevistó un par de días.
He looked for me and he was interviewing me for a couple of days.
Al término de las cuales me dice Luis Fernando.
At the end of which he said to Luis Fernando.
Todo lo que tú compartes y comentas suena muy interesante.
All the things you tell about and share with us, it sounds very interesting.
Pero yo como periodista, ¿cómo puedo comprobar que lo que tú dices es verdad?
But how can I, as a journalist that I am, how can I see that you're telling the truth?
Pues es muy simple, le digo.
It's very easy, I said to him.
¿Por qué no solicitamos una comunicación y les preguntamos si se pueden presentar?
We can organize a presentation, an encounter. We can ask them if they are willing to present themselves.
Y este nivel de experiencias se llaman contactos programados.
And this type of experiences are called program contacts.
Donde uno telepáticamente se comunica con los guías, con estos seres.
Where one person communicates with these beings, these guides.
Que Dios nos da una fecha.
And we get a date from them,
un lugar, una hora,
a place and a time
en la cual han de estar sus naves.
In which they come with their ships.
Bueno,
well,
es que te habían comunicado que la primera semana de diciembre.
Well, the thing is that they had communicated to me that in the first week of December. Of that year, 1990, they were going to be present in one place.
Me dijeron que siete personas podían acudir a este contacto programado.
They said that only seven people could be there in this program contact.
Y es así que lo llama Valentín y le digo que el contacto estaba confirmado y que podíamos salir, que le elija siete periodistas que de su confianza.
And then I called Valentin and I said that he could choose seven people whom he trusted and that they could be there.
Y es así que a las 9 de la noche, que era la hora prefijada para el contacto, tal como lo habían anticipado.
It was 9 in the evening, that was the programmed time. It was this way it has been programmed at 9 in the evening.
Comenzó a evolucionar un objeto.
Then we saw an object moving.
Que lograron registrarlo con sus cámaras justamente Valentín y los corresponsales tanto de Rusia como de Bolivia que había llevado.
And different correspondents, both from Valentín and Russia and Bolivia, they could register this movement.
Al día siguiente, Valentín me vuelve a llamar muy emocionado y me dice si era posible volver, pero esta vez con los la central noticiosa de la posta.
Next time, Valentín called to me. He was very excited and he asked me if he could come with all the people from the agency Novosti.
Valentín, esto no es como el pan que se come todos los días.
Valentín, this is not as the bread you eat every day.
Recientemente, hace unos años atrás, fui invitado a un congreso.
Recently, several years ago, I was invited to a congress
in
Hawaii.
Este congreso era organizado por el cofundador de la organización internacional Exopolitik.
This congress was organized for the coordinator of the international geopolitics organization.
Exopolitik of Galactic Diplomacy, liderizada por el doctor Michael Salar.
And the person who arranged it was Dr. Michael Salar.
Bueno, como buen investigador, Michael Salar se interesa mucho en las experiencias que compartimos.
As a good investigator, Michael Salar is very interested in the experiences we share.
Y dos meses después de estar en Hawaii.
And 2 months before that we were in Hawaii.
Simplemente no se viene solo, sino con un grupo de 12 personas.
And then you don't have to come alone any longer, but with a group of 12 people.
Justamente para investigar y compartir.
Just to investigate and share.
La trascendencia de las experiencias de contacto que venía manteniendo.
The transcendency of my of the contact experiences I had been maintaining.
En la cordillera de los Andes.
In the Andes range on Lake Titicaca.
Pues bien.
Well.
Michael Sala, lo tenemos aquí justamente en un centro de activación e iniciación solar que tenemos a orillas del lago Titicaca.
Then here we have Michael Sala
en un centro que tenemos a orillas del lago Titicaca.
This is a center we have on the shore of the Titicaca Lake.
Y tal como se había establecido y programado,
as it had been established and programmed, they happened as well, contact experiences of programmed experiences.
Este es el informe que él realiza justamente para la agrupación Exopolitik. Ustedes pueden googlear un poco.
This is the report he made for this Exopolitical organization.
Pero como él manifiesta en sus propias palabras.
But he writes with his own words.
Durante la noche en el cielo.
During the night in the sky,
varios ovnis fueron vistos.
Several UFOs were seen.
Uno en particular se encendió de manera espectacular.
One in particular shined in a particular in a spectacular way.
Y otro fue visto durante varios minutos.
And the other one was seen during several minutes.
En una posición inmóvil.
In an immobile position.
Donde parecía parpadear emitiendo una energía que todos
And it seems that it was emanating an energy felt by everyone.
Esto es bien interesante porque no lo digo yo.
This is very interesting because this is not me who says this.
Lo dice justamente un grupo de investigadores liderizado por Michael Sala.
This is said by a group of investigators leaded by Michael Sala.
De una experiencia que tuvimos no fortuita.
This is an experience we had and no casual.
Sino que esto se dio justamente producto de la programación en el momento que nosotros estábamos entrando en comunicación y contacto con los niños.
This was a product of program. This happened just in the moment we were having contact with these guides.
Es que evidentemente comienzan a aparecer varias luces desplazándose en el cielo a distancia inicialmente.
In fact, we saw several lights in the sky and we saw that first from the distance.
Luego, una se nos acerca y nos manda un haz de luz muy intenso, que es lo que describe Michael Sala.
And in fact, one of them came closer to us and saw a halet of light that is described by Michael Sala.
Y luego, se acerca un objeto a la distancia, comienza a descender.
And afterwards, an object in the distance started to descend.
Y para asombro de todos, este objeto se queda estático encima del grupo.
And to our astonishment, this object was hanging without movement above us, above the group.
Y debajo de la panza del objeto comenzamos todos a ver una suerte como de lucecitas que se encienden y se apagan.
And below, on below this object, we all started to see a group of lights on and off.
Mientras que sentíamos que nos estaban enviando, emitiendo una especial energía.
Why we were all feeling that we were emanating, they were sending to us a kind of energy.
En muchos medios de televisivos, de prensa escrita, de televisión.
In the means of television, the press, and different. They have been showing different filmings on Lake Titicaca and different places.
In programas tanto en Estados Unidos, en NBC, en Telemundo, Univision, en fin.
Different programs in the USA, Eurovision, Telemundo.
In Europa.
Here in Europe.
Mucho la trascendencia de las experiencias de contacto, sobre todo.
Many things are being showed from different contact experiences, especially in South America.
No solo se han dado experiencias de contacto programado con periodistas o investigadores.
not only we have seen experiences with journalists and other investigators, but we had these encounters as well as an open invitation for all the participants in contact groups.
Por ejemplo, aquí se encuentran alrededor de 19 participantes de distintos países.
Here we can see 19 participants from different countries.
Esto fue en 2012, a orillas del lago Titicaca.
This was in year 2012 on the shore of Lake Titicaca.
Se puede observar cómo por tres cámaras diferentes pudieron registrar el paso de dos objetos al mismo tiempo.
And the passing by of two objects could be registered by two different cameras at the same time.
A plena luz del día.
In the middle of the day.
Hace un mes y medio atrás,
1.5 months ago,
también convocamos a un nuevo encuentro programado en lo que se conoce como el Salar de Uyuni.
We organized as well another programmed encounter in what is called the Salar of Uyuni.
A este encuentro también asistieron alrededor de, bueno, en realidad más de 100 personas.
To this place, they came around 100 people, more than 100 people.
De 100 países.
More than 100 people coming from 16 different countries.
Y como siempre, también pudimos ser testigos presenciales de la presencia de las naves de estos seres.
And as always, we all of us were witnesses of these spaces from these people who are always accompanying us.
En todo momento, tanto como desde 1977 hasta este año 2014.
All the time from this moment in 1977, from this year 2014,
el contacto está más que vigente.
Contact is more than present.
Y me encuentro aquí también para hacerles una invitación.
And I'm here to make an invitation to you.
Para dos trascendentales, muy importantes encuentros que se han de dar el próximo año.
For two encounters that are going to be next year.
Uno.
The one here in the very Europe,
in
Mont-Saint-Michel, in France,
para el solsticio de verano,
for the summer solstice,
donde estaremos cuatro días compartiendo justamente lo que se conoce como la línea del dragón.
And we will, there will be 4 days in which we will be sharing what is known with the name the line of the dragon.
Para que cada uno tenga también la oportunidad de interiorizarse y conectar con las ancianas maestras.
So that everyone will have the opportunity to be in contact with the White Brotherhood and with the guys that are contacting us. And the second encounter will be in August again in Bolivia. In which is known the highest volcano in the planet.
Como es el Sahama.
That is the Sahama. Very well.
Entonces, son muchas las experiencias que se han ido dando, compartiendo, viviendo con la prensa, con los periodistas, con grupos de personas.
There are many experiences now that we have been sharing with different people, investigators, journalists, with the press.
Todo basado justamente en esta experiencia maravillosa de contacto con los guías de Venus.
All based in this marvelous experience with the Venusian guide. As well as with the elder masters of the White Brotherhood.
Desde
1977, since 1977,
las experiencias de contacto se fueron dando con distintas civilizaciones que nos visitan.
Contact experiences were given with different civilizations that visit us.
Bien lo dijo Terje al inicio de esta conferencia.
Terje said that very well at the beginning of this conference.
He tenido 5 oportunidades de contacto físico directo con estos seres.
I have had 5 opportunities of direct physical contact with these beings.
De las cuales en 2 oportunidades tuve la maravillosa experiencia de transportación.
Of which 2 opportunities I had of direct transportation.
Y ahora justamente lo que vamos a compartir aquella que aporta en este tiempo y en el ámbito de los contactados.
And the one that we're going to share now is the one of this time and contributing to the contactees.
Sobre la existencia ciertamente de vida en Venus.
About the existence of life in Venus.
La vida en Venus no es natural.
Life in Venus is not natural.
Ha sido acondicionada hace miles de años atrás.
It has been conditioned for thousands of years ago. By colonists arrived from the constellation of the Pleiades.
Los seres que se contactan conmigo,
those beings who contact me,
me comentaron que desde hace más de 12,000 años atrás,
said that it's 12,000, more than 12,000 years ago,
arribaron distintas civilizaciones al sistema solar.
Arrived, different civilizations arrived to the solar system. They foresaw that in these quadrants, quadrants of the universe, a new cosmic day, as it is known, was going to start. It was just in this area, precisely in this area, that important cosmic changes were going to start for the whole galaxy. And this, in this way, they travel from the Pleiades. And they established themselves in the second planet of our solar system. Other beings coming from the planet Orion established themselves in Jupiter.
En las lunas de Júpiter.
On the moons of Jupiter. And permanently interacting with the human race.
En esta conferencia nos vamos a abocar específicamente a lo que es justamente esta maravillosa civilización venusina.
In this conference we're going to focus in this marvelous Venusian civilization.
De la cual soy testigo presencial de que sí existe
vida. Of which I'm an eyewitness that in fact there's life there.
Sin embargo, antes de interiorizarnos un poco lo que fue mi propia experiencia.
On the other hand, before we deepen ourselves in that, what was my personal experience?
Veamos qué es lo que dice nuestra ciencia al respecto.
We're going to see first what our science says referring to that.
Si hay algo en lo que ha aportado nuestra propia ciencia es que en Venus no existe vida natural.
One of the things that, in fact, our science has contributed to is the fact that in Venus there doesn't exist natural life.
Ciertamente, las condiciones climatológicas son
extremas. Certainly, the climatic conditions are extreme.
Sin embargo, a pesar de ello, ustedes saben que los satélites que envió
on despite of that, you know that the satellites sent by the Soviet Union, they did register some certain life conditions presented here.
El doctor
Dr. Kondomatik, that this is the director of the Science Academy over there in Russia, presents precisely some of these proofs. They could register that in a few minutes when the few satellites of this came to the atmosphere, Venusian atmosphere. And they showed that in Venus, in fact, there's life, not life as we know it, but that it existed.
En la década de los 50,
in the 1950s,
apareció este gran personaje.
We have this big character person,
conocido como George Adamski.
Known to us as George Adamski.
George Adamski is de origen polaco.
George Adamski is from Polish origin.
Y él desde el 52 en adelante sostenía mantener experiencias de contacto con seres de Venus.
And from 1562 onwards, he sustained that he was maintaining experiences with beings from Venus.
El aporte que ha dado no solo científicamente, sino ufológicamente, es enorme.
His contribution, not only
es muy grande. No nos llama por nada la atención de que actualmente está enterrado.
His contribution, not only physically but psychologically, is enormous. And he's buried in the cemetery in Arlington, in Virginia. This is a cemetery where only the buried American military and heroes. George Adamski has received a medal given to him by the Pope John
23.
This is the experiences told by George Adamski and some of them that we had in Bolivia. This is a filming made by Adamski. This is a filming of the objects, the spaceships approaching us in year 2004, in which I say our contact experiences. And the one is one of the motherships filmed by George Adamski, and the other one is another mothership that I got to film myself later. Here we can see the similarity of this object with the typical dome above. What you are seeing here
es lo que se llama el inicio de la materialización de un portal interdimensional.
Is the initiation of the materialization of a portal.
No es que yo me fui volando a través de una nave.
It's not that I went flying through a spaceship
al segundo planeta de nuestro sistema solar.
To the second planet or the second planet of our solar system. What these beings actually do is the opening of these portals,
a los cuales nos invitan a ingresar,
through which they invite us to go.
Esos portales aceleran toda nuestra estructura atómica molecular.
These portals accelerate our molecular structure. And this enables us to be projected to the place where they're waiting for us. In the words of a being of Venus, the thing you see now,
se llama un pliegue cósmico,
is a cosmic wrinkle
que une dos planos temporalmente,
that links temporary two levels,
dos lugares, tiempo y espacio como uno solo,
two places in time and space like one.
A través de la generación de concentración de energía
through the generation of the concentration of ultrasolar energy in a camp of torsion, helicoidal.
El anillo de energía crea un campo magnético.
The energy ring creates a magnetic field
de energía plásmica.
Of plasmic energy.
La misma que posibilita la fusión de planos.
The same one that enables the fusion of levels.
Y la conexión de realidades.
And the connection of realities
a tiempos alternativos controlados por
to controllable alternative times.
Eso es para los seres de Venus, estos pliegues, estas concentraciones de energía lumínica.
These cosmic wrinkles are from the beings of Venus. This concentration of luminic energy.
Estos portales, cuando los viví, era todavía ciencia ficción para nuestra humanidad.
When I experienced these portals, this was like science fiction for our humanity.
Sin embargo, estamos viviendo hoy por hoy una edad en nuestra tecnología.
But up to the date, we are living an age in our technology. Where all imaginable things are possible.
Donde ya se está rompiendo la velocidad de la luz.
When we are already breaking the speed of light.
Donde ya se están creando membranas de invisibilidad a través de la nanotecnología.
Where there are already been created visibility membranes through technology.
Donde se están creando realmente aparatos de transportación.
Where there have already been created apparatus of transportation.
Entonces, pensamos que eran impensables.
Then we thought they were impensable.
Y que no son sino apenas así la semilla de lo que ya estas civilizaciones manejan.
And in other words, they're already the cement of the civilization that is already been formed.
Quienes han tenido la oportunidad de escuchar
The people who had already had the opportunity to listen to a conference of mine.
Recordarán que cuando comparto mi experiencia en
Venus, will remember that the times where in which I share my experience in Venus.
Comento que lo primero que me llama la atención cuando llego a este lugar es ese cielo maravillosamente encendido.
I always say that the first thing that catches my eye when I come to this marvelous place is the shining sky. This is a reproduction of an old conference of mine.
Donde explico justamente que el cielo estaba completamente iluminado por ráfagas multicolores.
Where I precisely explain that the sky is shining with illuminated multicolor lights.
Como los seres de Venus me explican de que el viento solar crea ese efecto justamente.
And the beings of Venus explain it like that is the effect of the solar wind that creates that.
Más cercano, comentaba yo, a lo que había observado en Venus.
And what I was explaining myself of the things that I had seen in Venus.
Era justamente algo de lo cual ustedes pueden disfrutarlo hasta año.
It was precisely that some of you can see every year.
Son las auroras, ¿verdad?
That's the aurora.
Es así de que este año, fíjense ustedes.
But it is like this that this year you see.
Más de 20 años después de que tuvieran mi experiencia en contacto y de transportación a Venus.
20 years after I had my experience of contact and transportation to Venus.
Nuestra propia ciencia.
Our own science.
Fotografía lo que denomina aurora gloria.
Arcoiris gloria. Take a picture of what is called aurora biloria or biloria rainbow. And where this is registered? In Venus.
Efectivamente, nuestra propia ciencia está corroborando lo que nosotros venimos y sostenemos haber visto y vivido hace décadas.
In fact, our own science corroborates the things we said to have seen and experienced for decades.
Esta imagen que ustedes observan tiene la chiquita distancia de 1,200 kilómetros.
The thing you're seeing now has the little distance of 1,200 kilometers.
Efectivamente, nuestra ciencia ha corroborado de que en el cielo venusino se dan fenómenos maravillosos.
In fact, our science has been corroborating that in Venus takes place very, very beautiful phenomena and multicolored. Equal as to those that I lived myself
en la década de los 80.
In the 1980s.
Pues bien,
What do you think the Venusian likes guides look like? They have characteristics, very Nordic characteristics. With one particularity. And the lobe of the ear is a little more prominent than normal. Their height is 180,
185.
In general, they have light hair, light eyes, very, very human in form. This reminds us to the origin and beginnings of the different cultures here in Europe and in America. You might have heard talk about the muses in Greece. And in America, we talk a lot of the goddess La Orejona. But the Incas and the priests wear those selves rings to be similar to those beings that were in contact with them. You can see that on that picture in Inca jewelry. After several months of preparation, regularly going to the camp, having auto control experiences, in which they ask me to intern myself in the field in the darkness of night. So that I would be able to overcome my own fears to the unknown. And then one thinks, okay, I have my friends here near me, what kind of fears I can feel? And then you start to walk there in the field, three steps, then 10 meters, then you start hearing steps behind you, and you start getting like goose pimples. You start feeling fear. You think that someone is going to attack you, is going to attack you behind your back. And then you understand that you have lots of fears inside of you. They asked me that I should sustain a vegetarian nourishment. I was told that we have to eliminate in our diet all those things that are not natural. All those things that are an obstacle to achieve our vibrations. Why and what for? If we have a very intense experience to the emotional or physical level, our mind automatically activates a system of self-protecting. And that is known as amnesia.
Entonces, la preparación,
then the preparation,
lo que busca es que nosotros estemos plenamente conscientes,
wants that we are completely conscious in the moment in which this contact is given.
Porque el contacto con estos seres,
because the contact with these beings,
no se da para que nosotros hagamos un viaje turístico,
is not given to us so that we participate in a touristical journey.
Que por cierto, qué bueno que es.
By the way, that is very good too.
Es para que nosotros aprendamos,
this is for us to learn and be conscious that if they exist civilizations that have achieved and overcome the conflicts in which we're living in as a society, then we as human beings, we can achieve that too. The human being learns by imitation since he's born. Then if we realize that there are civilizations that have achieved
nuestro ideal,
our ideal,
nos sirve como referente para que nosotros, con nosotros mismos, nos ayudemos y aprendemos.
That it serves us as a reference so that we can help ourselves and we can do that too.
Y ahora,
and now, this level of harmony when human being has overcome wars, famine, when sickness has been overcome as well, famine, in which everything is in perfect harmony, then it is possible as well that we can achieve that too. But they don't want to live and do for us the things that we are that is given to us to have an experience of. Then they designed these contact programs in small groups or isolated contacts, so that we can get acquainted with their reality, doing that that the human being can't help it themselves as human beings.
Ese es el propósito del contacto.
This is the purpose of this contact.
Una ventana abierta para que nosotros tomemos conciencia.
An open window to make us conscious of our own realization potential. They have been always telling us in the first contact to come to us that you have to learn to be observant and see yourselves this contact with the oneself. Only as long as we learn to see in our own dimension,
así como humana, divina,
as well as in the divine, then we will be able to see the things that surround us in their proper nature. When this energy of light was materialized, in the Andes range.
Yo, desde hace varios meses atrás les decía a los guías, ¿cuándo nos vamos a ver? ¿Cuándo nos vamos a ver?
I was asking all the time to these guides, when are we going to see each other? When are we going to see each other?
Como un niño cuando está exigiendo un juguete que quiere desde hace tiempo.
As a child who is nagging all the time about a toy he's been wanted from a long time ago. And then they asked, do you think you're ready? And what do you think I said? Yes. Well, then I was invited to the field.
Dijeron que iba a acercarse una nave, iba a proyectar este campo de energía.
And then they said that a spaceship was going to approach me, and that the spaceship was going to illuminate this energy field.
Y que toda vez que estuviese materializado, ingresase dentro de él.
And as long as this would be materialized, I had just to come inside.
Toda vez que este portal de luz se materializa completamente,
then every time this portal of light is completely materialized,
me acerco,
then I go there.
Trato de tocarlo porque era muy intensa la luz.
Then I try to touch it because always the light is very intense.
Y siento como un hormigueo cuando la percibo.
And then I feel like a prickling when I perceive that.
Y sin más, comienzo.
And without further ado, I start walking inside there. And what do you think I feel when this intensity of light makes me close my eyes for a moment?
Después de tantos meses de preparación,
after so many months of preparation,
controlando mis
emociones, controlling my emotions, maintaining a correct diet, relaxing meditations.
Me dio miedo.
I was afraid
sentí que perdía control.
Because simply I was feeling that I was losing control over my own body.
Es como cuando estamos volando en el avión,
is as we are flying on a plane.
Y el avión, comienza a pasar por una bolsa de aire.
And the plane starts going through a bag of air.
Y nuestro estómago sencillamente se suspende.
And our stomach simply feels suspended.
Sentí una pérdida de gravedad inmediata.
I felt a loss of gravity immediately.
Y como si una gran ventosa me estuviera sacando hacia adelante.
And as if a ventos were taking my inside outside.
Mucha presión en el reservo, en la sien.
A lot of pressures in the temples.
Y, un especial calor.
And a special heat.
Pues bien, lo primero que observo,
well, the first thing I saw was I was in a sky specially starred. It looked to me like I saw a being very similar to the one of the image. And he said, my name is Etel.
Y, no temas.
Don't be afraid.
Inmediatamente cuando me dice no temas, me envuelve, siento yo, en su campo de energía.
Immediately, after I heard don't be afraid, I felt myself surrounded by his field of energy.
Y de tener esas sensaciones de temor, simplemente comienza a infundirseme una sensación de paz y
and the sensation of fear I had earlier, it was converted suddenly in a sensation of peace.
Me comienza a explicar que lo que me estaba llamando la atención, que era ese cielo especial y hermosamente encendido de colores, de multicolores.
He started to explain to me that the thing that had caught my eye, this star full of stars and colors, it was a product of the solar wind that was arriving. And that with a mattress of clouds that surrounds Venus, produces this that our science precisely have gotten to photograph nowadays and is known as the glorial rainbow. I was about 2 hours with them. They showed to me the system of life they have.
Las construcciones, muy a diferencia de nosotros, los ángulos.
Their constructions are very different from us. They don't have edges.
Ellos simplemente usan círculos.
They use circles.
O cones.
Or cones.
Como en Venus.
Like in Venus.
Muy parecido a lo que nosotros conocemos como en Norteamérica, por ejemplo, los tipus.
Very similar to what we know in North America, the tipis.
Ellos sostienen que Las pirámides ciertamente amplifican la energía.
They sustain that precisely pyramids amplify energy.
Pero así como amplifica energía positiva,
but as well as they amplify positive energy,
puede amplificar energía negativa.
They can amplify a negative energy too.
Y es lo que pasó justamente en Egipto.
And this is what happened precisely in Egypt. When in ancient Egypt the priests lost when in ancient Egypt the priests lost their spirituality, they made that way that pyramids that a contrary energy emanated from these pyramids. Different from the purpose they were conceived for.
Entonces, ellos para evitar justamente todo esto simplemente no usan ángulos, todo lo hacen en círculos.
Then they to avoid precisely this, they don't use edges, they use circles.
Explicaron que la vida que ellos mantenían en Venus es artificial, obviamente.
They explained to me that the life in Venus was artificial, obviously. Their population doesn't surpass the 6 million 6 million people.
Y que el 60-65% de su población.
And that the 65% of their population is feminine.
Bendito Dios.
God blessed. Is for that reason that history of humanity we hear to speak of the Venusian muses. We hear speaking of La Orejona, the starlight goddess of Venus. Unlike this marvelous presence of Venus has had a positive influence in our civilization.
Me explicaron que la vida que ellos han desarrollado es semi-subterránea.
And they explained to me that the life they had developed is semi-subterranean.
Y que no porque no tengan las condiciones de acondicionarla.
And it's not about it's not because they have they don't have the conditions to condition it life as we have it here on Earth. Curiously, they maintain that the more developed is a civilization is. The more in contact will be with the original mass of the Earth.
¿Por qué creen ustedes que uno de los grandes problemas de nuestra sociedad es el estrés?
Why do you think that one of the principal problems of our society is stress?
Sobre todo generado en las grandes ciudades.
Above all generated in big cities.
Es porque la mayor cantidad de personas que se encuentran en las grandes ciudades.
This is because the larger the amount of people located in the big cities.
Viven en los rascacielos.
They live in skyscrapers.
Y no están en contacto con la tierra.
And they're not that way, they're not in contact with Earth.
Con la Pachamama, con la
madre. With Pachamama, with the Mother Earth.
No estar en contacto justamente con la energía telúrica.
Because precisely they're not in contact with the telluric energy.
Hace que nuestros cuerpos se
desestabilicen. This makes our bodies to desestabilize themselves. For that reason, for them, it's completely understandable why our society.
En los mayores estándares de vida se dan en los penthouses, en los lugares que menor conexión se encuentran con la tierra.
In fact, they point that in the better is the standard of life, they build this penthouse, and this means that they're very little in contact from Earth.
Es necesario. necesario que por lo menos una vez a la semana descansemos y entremos en contacto con la tierra.
And it's very necessary that at least once a week we come in contact with earth.
Para estabilizar nuestras emociones y
to make our emotions and our bodies come into stability. They taught to me many techniques as when it comes to the tackling of energies.
Algo de lo que el lunes en un seminario que vamos a dar justamente vamos a compartir.
About this, we're going to have a seminar on Monday in which we will be sharing this.
Sobre esta información y las técnicas que nos han dado para poder desarrollarnos en el plano físico, mental y espiritual.
About these techniques that are given to us by them, so that we can evolve in the level physically and emotional level. People who want to take part in this, they can do it through the organizer Terje. They show that to me. You're seeing it now. They have archives of Earth known to them as Akashic Registries. Those are golden plates and registered in ideograms.
La relación que tienen estas civilizaciones con la raza humana.
And they contain a fact about the relation that these civilizations have with human race.
Y que ya en lo que va de los últimos años ha comenzado a ser compartida.
And in the last few years, this relation have started to be shared.
Pero me dijeron algo muy importante.
But they said to me something very important.
Que ya de retorno a tierra.
Already back on Earth,
iba a encontrar varios lugares en el planeta con estos símbolos.
I was going to see several places in the planet with those symbols.
Y que era la señal de que en esos lugares,
and that was, would be a sign that in those places,
venía realizando actividades lo que se conoce como la Gran Hermandad Blanca.
That in those places were carrying on activities that known as the Great White Brotherhood.
De que aquí en la Tierra existían terrestres como nosotros, pero con una conciencia superior.
That here on Earth they were terrestrial people just like us, but with a superior conscience.
Y que parte de nuestra misión no solo era contactar con estos seres extraterrestres.
And that part of our mission was only not to come in contact with these extraterrestrial beings,
no, entrar en contacto con estos extraterrestres,
but as well to come in contact with these extraterrestrials,
o sea, terrestres como nosotros,
that is to say terrestrial like us,
superior
conscience, but with a superior conscience.
Y que son custodios naturales de esta maravillosa sabiduría.
And that they are natural keepers of this wonderful knowledge.
Ellos vendrían a ser descendientes de una otrora y antigua milenaria civilización.
And they were to be descendants of a millenary and ancient civilization.
Conocida como la Atlántida.
And known to us as the Atlántida.
Los Atlantes, los patriarcas Atlantes, habrían resguardado su sabiduría.
The patriarchs of and priests of Atlantis, and they had kept their wisdom in different energetic places around the planet, specifically in two great vortices.
Como quiera que una imagen vale por mil palabras.
However, a picture is worth more than 1,000 words.
Aquí compartimos una recreación que han hecho.
Here we share a recreation that has been made.
Sobre cómo se desenvolvió mi experiencia en contacto con los guías en el momento en que ingreso justamente.
About my experience with the guides in the moment when I precisely come in. With this field of light known as Zendra, an interdimensional orifice created artificially,
las construcciones en general, como ustedes pueden observar, son cónicas.
As you can see here, the construction are conical.
Llegué a un pequeño valle que se llama Orea.
I came to a little valley called Orea.
Que significaría algo así como el valle del silencio.
That means something like the valley of silence.
Un pequeño centro espiritual que tienen ellos.
A little spiritual center that they have.
Desde el cual controlan y manejan lo que es el desenvolvimiento de la vida en esta maravillosa civilización.
From where they control and manage the development of life in this marvelous civilization. Time rush.
Sin embargo, vamos a tratar de resumir,
but we're going to try to summarize
lo más posible la información que hemos venido a compartir.
The bigger amount of information that I'm here to share with you.
Como les comentaba, en Venus me hablaron mucho sobre cómo en la Tierra.
As I was telling, in Venus, they told me a lot about how on Earth,
la energía cósmica se descompone en dos polos.
Cosmic energy decomposes in two poles.
El polo positivo o masculino.
The positive pole or masculine.
Ingresaría por el Asia en los míticos y milenarios Himalayas del Tíbet.
That had the center in the Tibet, in the Himalayan.
Es por eso de que desde hace milenios,
it's for that reason, millennia ago,
nosotros venimos recibiendo mucha información espiritual del
Oriente. We have been receiving a lot of spiritual information from the East.
De los lamas, los monasterios.
The lamas, the monasteries.
Siempre ha estado toda esta zona cargada de mucho misticismo.
That area has always been loaded with a lot of mysticism and spirituality.
Sin embargo, después de la Segunda Guerra Mundial,
after Second World War,
esta actividad energética y espiritual,
this energetic and spiritual activity
se activó en América,
was activated in America.
Y en América, particularmente en lo que es la cordillera de los Andes.
In America, particularly in which is the Andean Range and Lake Titicaca.
En su dualidad natural, o sea, en su aspecto femenino.
It's a natural duality, that is to say, in their feminine appearance.
¿Qué es lo que significa cuando hablamos de que está activa la energía femenina de la energía cósmica del planeta?
And what does it mean that the feminine energy is active in the planet?
Significa que nuestro aspecto sensitivo y espiritual.
And that this means that our spiritual and sensitive level
ha de comenzar a manifestarse.
Is going to begin to make itself present.
Por eso que a partir justamente de la conclusión de la Segunda Guerra Mundial.
So precisely parting from Second World War.
Todas las escuelas herméticas,
all the hermetic schools
comienzan a abrirse.
Start to open.
Toda la información comienza a estar al alcance.
All information starts to be to surround us.
De quien se sienta llamado a vivir su proceso de despertar.
To all of them who have felt a call to live the process of awakening.
De tal manera de que hoy por hoy no hay nada que no esté a nuestro alcance.
In that way, today there's nothing that we cannot achieve.
Si es que acaso nosotros lo deseamos.
If we so wish.
Pues bien.
Well.
En este maravilloso vórtice de energía.
In this marvelous vortex of energy. we have a exists a contact triangle.
Manifestado en, es decir, en hitos naturales, como son dos grandes nevados en la cordillera.
Manifested into natural milestones, like in the cordillera, in the range. And this point, which is Yaguanaco. In reality, this is a ruin.
Toda esta zona, como es de suponerse,
all this area, as we have to suppose, is considered within the geothermal field as a hot area.
Permanentemente se vienen registrando objetos, naves, tanto por nosotros como por la gente en las ciudades.
They have been registered here regularly, contacts, not only by us, but for the people who live in those cities.
Nosotros mismos,
we ourselves,
así como esto se ha registrado en los anteriores años, este año en particular,
As well as this has been registered in previous years, this year particularly,
con mi pareja nos encontramos en esta zona maravillosa de los Andes.
I was with my partner in this marvelous area of the Andes, which is one of the contact points in this triangle that we just saw. And this is not the last filming that we saw, but yes, the last filming that we recorded. Of the typical lenticular ship that approaches us. And in the moment when it's flying above us, it makes a change of direction and leaves. As it was moving, as this object was moving, the colors were changing.
Esto fue el 29 de marzo.
This was on March the 29th. And this is the archaeological complex of Tiwanaku.
Para los que no saben,
for those who do not know that,
recientemente en Tiwanaku se han descubierto este tipo de monolitos.
Recently in Tiwanaku have been discovered this type of monoliths,
en los cuales hay inscripciones,
in which there are inscriptions pre-Sumerian. What does that mean?
Que la historia,
that history,
tal como nosotros la conocemos,
as we know it,
está muy mal contada.
Is not well told.
No nos sorprenda que en realidad la cultura no salió de Europa.
We do not have to be surprised thinking that culture doesn't come from Europe. But rather from these places in which we find millenary ruins. And just as the guides had advised me, there are many places with ideograms, shapes that scientists think it can be Sumerian writing. Recently, I don't know if you have already heard about that, this fossilized human foot in volcanic stone. And do you know how old that human foot is? 15 million years. This is unthinkable. Do you have a notion of that? Is it supposed that the appearance of the Homo sapiens is 60 million years, 70 million years, and that exaggerating? And what is a human foot doing there? 15 million years ago. This nature of contacts allows us to see that our history is really, in reality, completely different to the one we know.
Creo no equivocarme.
I think I'm not wrong.
Pero la mayor cantidad de los
contactados, but the majority of the contactees, we have been turned almost into archaeologists. Because many of these experiences have directed us and taken us to the origins. And one of the most ancient millenary origins that has our humanity is precisely Tiwanaku. And the image now is showing what is called as the gate of Sun or Venusian calendar. Because there it is reflecting the days of rotation of Venus in connection with the Sun.
Ancient sites lies just a few hundred yards away, of relatively little interest to most visitors. Pumapunku is a field of stone ruins that both thrills and stimulates the imaginations of ancient alien theorists. In my opinion, the most significant piece of evidence that we have in this entire ancient astronaut puzzle is Pumapunku in the highland of Bolivia. While the pyramids at Giza are incredible feat of achievement, compared to Pumapunku, the pyramids are child's play. Logic does not exist at Pumapunku because there we have megalithic structures which just lie about this entire site as if ripped apart by some sort of a great force. The blocks of Pumapunku were so finely cut that they once perfectly interlocked, like the pieces of an elaborate puzzle. But with the nearest quarry over 10 miles away, how did these colossal stones, some weighing hundreds of tons, even get here?
We are talking about the place 4,000 meters over sea level. That means there are no trees up there, which you could use for rollers. Nothing grows except a few grasses and bushes. I have stood in front of many monuments. However, Pumapunku takes the crown, because what we find there is so inexplicable, so unachievable, that the question remains, how was it done and for what purposes? One of these platforms is 800 tons, and they are so smoothly polished. We have some stone, megalithic stones, with grooves which are just a few millimeters inside, which definitely cannot be made with Stone Age chisels. It doesn't work with Stone Age chisels, so there is another technology behind it.
The lines cut into these rocks are exactly straight and precisely the same depth from one end to the other.
One of the most intriguing things there is that the stones that were used there aren't sandstone, they're
only stone that's harder than diorite is diamond. So the only way that this could have been achieved is if the tools were tipped with diamonds.
Lo que este documental nos muestra,
what this documentary is showing us,
presentado por History Channel,
that is presented by the History Channel,
es que efectivamente, como ustedes han podido escuchar, es una de las ruinas más misteriosas que hay en la Tierra.
This makes it to one of the most mysterious ruins on Earth.
Les invito para que ustedes lo puedan encontrar en Google.
I encourage you to look it up in Google or YouTube.
Lo que el investigador no termina de decir es que efectivamente,
the thing that the investigator has not finished to say is that in fact,
la única manera en la que se puede cortar el diorito con
diamante, the only way to cut the diorite is with a diamond.
Pero el diamante es una piedra que no existe en Bolivia.
But the diamond is a stone that doesn't exist in Bolivia. And how this all was made?
Aquí está la respuesta.
This is the answer.
Efectivamente, no solo seres de Venus han estado en la Tierra, hay seres de Orión que han estado también interactuando.
We can say that not only beings of Venus have been on our Earth, beings of Orion has been on Earth as well. In this picture, you can see the skulls found in these ruins at Tiwanaku. Those are the approximate recreations of what supposedly they would be looking like.
Sin embargo, ustedes han debido leer esta noticia también.
But probably you have read in the news as well. That in Peru have been found 300 of those heads in a place known as Paracas. And recently there was in the news as well that the DNA of these skulls doesn't correspond to anything human. Don't believe in what I say. Investigate by yourselves. Leave that by yourselves, by your own means.
Lo que está aconteciendo es una liberación de
información. What is happening is a liberation of information is taking place.
Que nos hace ver que verdaderamente nuestra ascendencia, así como humana,
what makes us to see that our descendancy as humans, they have an origin certainly extraterrestrial. And with this change of vibrations which is being carried out to a planetary level,
este código sanguíneo,
this blood code
está comenzando a liberarse,
is beginning to liberate. To liberate, to open in itself in a way that we know about our real origins.
Pues bien,
well,
aquí en Tiwanaku justamente se han dado también experiencias de contacto con los guías.
Here precisely in Tiwanaku, we have had experiences with the guides as well. Perhaps this is one of the classical filmings of the things I'm talking about, where you can see the typical lenticular object moving itself around its own axis and producing vapor. Why this object is producing vapor as it's moving around its axis? This is like this, that it was in the Bolivian altiplano where this object was filmed.
Hace tanto frío en el amanecer,
it is so cold at the sunrise
que, hasta las piedras se
it is so cold that that stones can break. The atmosphere is very dry. And the reaction that this object creates when moves around its axis creates a vapor.
Todo lo que hemos visto está a orillas justamente de este maravilloso lugar conocido como el lago Titicaca.
All the marvelous things we've seen are located around this wonderful place, Lake Titicaca. Once of you who have had the chance to be at the Lake Titicaca, you could be appreciate that this lake is divided into two sections, the minor lake and the major lake.
Y ambos están conectados por este estrecho entre
And both are connected by this what in reality is a strait.
Es conocido como el estrecho de Tiquina.
That is known as the Strait of Tiquina. Up to today, geologists
nos explican por qué en este lugar existen dos cortes longitudinales.
Can't explain why in this place there are two longitudinal cuts.
Como si una gran pala mecánica hubiera extraído esta porción de
terreno, ¿no? As if a big mechanical shop would have extracted a part of the lake.
Inundando toda esta porción de tierra, creando un lago artificial.
Flooding that section of Earth, creating an artificial lake. The Venusian Gate, in reality, they had anticipated to me that the internal positive government of our humanity, where they used this marvelous tool called the solar disk.
Tenía un gran centro iniciático en este lago
menor. Had a big initiating center in this minor lake.
Conocido como la Aymara, que es el idioma nativo, Winyaimarca.
Known in the Aymara language, the native language there, as Winyaimarca. In the Aymara language, this means eternal city.
Pues bien,
well,
resulta que
it turns out that
efectivamente,
in fact,
llegué a saber de que todo lo que acontecía en esta zona andina,
and I came to know that all that had happened in this Andean sector,
no se había desarrollado al azar.
It hadn't happened casually. All these archaeological ruins in the Andean range and the geological points in the sea,
una suerte de red de energía,
they were composing an energy net
conocida como la cruz cuadrada o chacana,
known as the chacana or the square cross.
Para quienes saben algo de lo que es la cultura andina,
for those who know something about the Andean culture,
recordarán de que este es un símbolo que se usa mucho en la cultura andina.
You will remember that it's a symbol widely used in the Andean culture.
Y que representa en realidad los siete rayos.
And that in reality represents the seven rays.
Los incas heredaron un sistema de organización que ya existía antes y que le pusieron como nombre Taiwantinsuyo.
The Incas inherited a system of civilization that already existed from before, and they called it Taiwan.
Taiwantinsuyo. Y que se refería a las cuatro regiones.
And it refers to the four regions.
Cuando las cuatro regiones están unidas, o sea, las cuatro latitudes del planeta están unidos como uno solo.
When the four latitudes of the planet are united as one, then they form this square cross known to them as Chacana.
Y que fíjense ustedes lo que representa.
on pay attention to that what represents.
La Unión de la Huipala,
the Union of Huipala,
sus cuatro puntos,
in its 4 points,
forma la Chacana,
form the Chacana.
Y la Chacana,
and the Chacana
es la representación matemática,
is the mathematical representation
del movimiento de la
of the movement of the telluric energy. And then what happens when we take a stone and we throw it to a well? The laws of this energy dictates that we can see waves. And this is how energy operates, and they consciously use this way of operating energy for their constructions.
Por eso también hacían pirámides.
For this reason, they built pyramids as well.
Este es el mapa, o el plano, de una pirámide escalonada.
This is the map of a step pyramid.
Para que en los puntos más altos uno pueda entrar en contacto, así como la energía telúrica con la cósmica,
So in the highest points, one could come in contact with the telluric energy as well as with the cosmic energy, as if they were one.
Ciertamente nuestra ciencia vino corroborando lo que va de los últimos años.
It is indeed that our science in the last few years has corroborated.
Todo lo que ya de alguna manera habíamos ido viviendo también nosotros desde inicios de los 80.
All that in many ways we have already come into experience from the beginning of the 80s.
Tal como me habían anticipado los días en Venus, aquí en el retiro interior existe un centro espiritual.
As well as they had anticipated to me this Venusian guide, here we had as well an entire retreat.
Y que en nuestra propia ciencia, a través de un proyecto multinacional conocido como ACAPOR,
And in our own science, in an international project known with the names of ACOPO, ACACOR discovered this project has been directed by a group of Italians, Brazilians and Bolivians.
La testa del lido è a 43 metri di profondità. Siamo nel lago Titicaca, Bolivia, quota 4.000 sulle Ande. Il sub appartiene ad una spedizione archeologica che si è mossa dall'Italia, da Verona e Lucco. Dopo diverse trasferte, questa è la volta buona. Il gruppo ha fatto scoperte sensazionali che hanno guadagnato le prime pagine dei giornali sudamericani. Hanno scoperto una civiltà che risale a 5-6.000 anni prima di Cristo, quando secondo gli storici nel Piranha. Hanno trovato l'Eldorado? No, forse qualcosa di ancora più straordinario, la mitica Atlantide. Sì, perché i collegamenti ci sono. Se...
Muchos piensan que la Atlántida verdaderamente está en Bolivia.
Many think that Atlantis in reality is in Bolivia.
Han debido escuchar ustedes la teoría del arqueólogo inglés Jim Allen.
You might have heard the theory of the English archaeologist Jim Allen.
¿Quién sostiene que justamente la Atlántida está estaría justamente ahí, ¿verdad?
He sustains that the Atlantis in reality is located there.
Según mis experiencias de contacto,
according to my contact experiences,
Atlantis no estuvo en Bolivia.
Atlantis was not in Bolivia.
Pero sí existió una gran colonia Atlantis.
But it did exist a big colony of Atlanteans.
Porque ya en el pasado, antes incluso que los Atlantes, los lemures habían establecido un centro iniciático en toda esta zona.
And because even before that the Atlanteans were there, the lemures had already activated an initiator center there.
Porque sencillamente en toda esta área ingresa la energía. energía cósmica en su aspecto femenino.
Because simply in this area is concentrated the energy of the earth in his feminine appearance.
Y ellos la utilizaban conscientemente.
And they used it consciously.
Y es por eso que también, así como en la cordillera de los Andes,
for that reason, in the Andean range,
en el lago Titicaca hemos tenido maravillosas experiencias de contacto.
We have had a wonderful contact experience on the shores of Lake Titicaca. And as well as a wonderful encounter with an elder master of the White Brotherhood.
Este anciano maestro se llama Soromés.
This ancient elder master is called Soromés.
Mañana les muestro la fotografía.
Tomorrow I'm going to show you his picture. On the other hand, this ancient master came to me and said, "Beloved son, I'm here now in front of you because the moment has come in which I'm going to give you that key that will be able to open the great gate in the wall of conscience." When I heard those words that the ancient master was saying to me, I felt a great internal commotion. The ancient master continued to say, "That key that will be able to open the gate in the wall of your conscience
es amar a Dios por sobre todas las cosas,
is love God over all
y a los demás,
and the others like yourself."
Cuando el amado anciano me dijo aquello,
when the beloved elder said that to me,
más que entender con la mente, comprendí con el corazón.
I was understanding what he said, not with my mind, but rather with my heart. That the infinite manifestation of God is love. The only way in which we come back to this wonderful source of light is through its own action. And what was the main action of love, but loving?
Pero para amar verdaderamente, nosotros debemos aprender a amarnos a nosotros.
But to love, really, we have to learn first to love ourselves.
Saber quiénes somos.
To know who we are.
De dónde venimos.
Where we come from.
Consecuentemente, hacia dónde vamos.
And consequently, where we are going to. That maxima is called the awakening of the conscious.
Lo que podemos nosotros dar a los
demás. To know what we have to give the others.
Y lo que requerimos para seguir
avanzando. And what we crave to go on.
No podemos dar a los demás lo que no hemos
aprendido en nosotros. We cannot give to the others the things we still haven't found in ourselves. And it is like this, that loving ourselves, it is the only way to love the others, not only this wonderful word that is given to us, but to all the things on it.
Cuando los ancianos maestros nos
hablan, when the ancient elders speak to us,
nos envuelven en su campo de energía,
they surround us in their energy field.
Y pueden decirnos una sola palabra,
and they can tell to us only a single word. But the level of comprehension that we receive comes loaded with a wonderful energy that makes us to understand, perceive the light of our life. And they manifest themselves with every single one of us. because simply the planet is evolving.
¿Qué significa?
What does that mean?
Que ellos van a seguir su propio proceso.
That they're going to continue their own evolution process.
Y todos y cada uno de nosotros,
and every single one of us is going to start to assume those roles and responsibilities. Constantly and everywhere we are.
Todo en este momento está
evolucionando. All in this very moment is evolving.
¿Han escuchado ustedes hablar en Sumatra, por ejemplo, cómo los orangutanes?
Have you heard about that in Sumatra, the orangutans?
Han descendido de los árboles.
Are evolved from trees.
Están haciendo sus casas como nosotros.
And they build their houses as we do. And how, for example, there are dolphins, elephants, that they try to imitate a human voice.
Todo está evolucionando.
All is evolving.
Nosotros no somos la excepción.
We are not an exception.
Tenemos que ser realmente el punto de inflexión.
We have to be in reality the inflection point. To open a new wonderful page in our dimension and to start writing it with light.
Pues bien,
well,
en el lado, pues, permanentemente se fueron también dando manifestaciones.
In the light, permanently they were giving to us other manifestations.
Es muy usual que cuando aparecen las naves,
it is very usual when the ships appear. You see this type of wheels. Yep, that was last year, that was in August.
Esta afirmación también fue analizada por el grupo de Exopolitik.
This filming was also analyzed by the Exopolitik group. That was in August last year. We had the encounter with a group of Italians. That was a project we were carrying out. It was called Initiatic Travels. Where it appeared this UFO or submarine underwater object. It can be seen clearly, like the solar light reflects themselves on this object.
Pues bien, el tiempo apremia, pero no quiero irme sin presentarles justamente estas fotos satelitales.
Well, time rush, but I don't want to leave from here without showing you these satellite pictures. Where we can see that in the minor lake it can be seen this internal retreat where they live the ancient masters of the White Brotherhood and there I had the opportunity to be present in the decade of the 80s. To finish, I invite you to see this recreation of what it can be found under Lake Titicaca. This sector of the lake was created artificially precisely to protect this tool known as the solar disk. Tomorrow we will be talking a little more about what this is, so you know what this solar disk is.
Y cómo incluso el mal manejo de esta energía hizo que desapareciese la antigua civilización
And how the bad managing of the solar disk produced the disappearance of the ancient civilization of Atlantis. That the axis of the Earth 17 degrees from its course. It's very well known that the whole of America is connected to each other with a net of tunnels and corridors. And that way, I had access to this wonderful center in the interior of Lake Titicaca, where I could come in contact with this wonderful energy. Which connects us directly with this wonderful cosmic conscience, from which one day we came from, and to which certainly, with certainty, we'll go back one day. When we can observe the vast infinite universe, we can see that on every single star that shines above us at night. A neuron of the great universal conscience. And we are a conscious part of this wonderful presence of light. And this, if it would be physically in front of us, would say to us, my little one, you are so important to me that without you, I wouldn't be complete. And this is this way we have to learn to feel ourselves. With our interior peace, we'll be able to have an influence on all the entire universe.
Si es que así lo deseamos.
If so, we wish. Many thanks
hasta cada momento y hasta siempre.
In this moment and forever.